First time, thanks for joining me. If it's not, welcome back. Thanks for coming back for some more lessons. Today's playthrough and guitar lesson is for the great song 1979 by the Smashing Pumpkins from the monster album Melancholy and Infinite Sadness. I chose this song because it's actually the same year I was born. Yep, I'm that old. But also, I love this song. It's a great song. It's got a great riff. I've always loved it. And I'm going to teach you how to play the main riff that runs through the song. Before I forget, make sure you subscribe and like and do all that stuff. It helps me out. I'll post it up on here somewhere, just so you can do that and hopefully give me some support. And then you'll get to check out the future lessons that I'm going to do. They're to be decided, but when I get to them, they'll be posted on here. So like my page, subscribe, do all that stuff, and I'd be really appreciative. Right, so I'm going to get on with the lesson and show you how to play the main riff. Okay, so the main riff for this song is really cool to play. It's really fun. It's really simple as well. It's not too complicated. It starts off with some octave chords. We start on the 6th fret, and I'm barring the 6th fret here on the A string, and then on the G string, I use my little finger. Now, traditionally, a lot of people use their 3rd finger and play those two notes, which is the A on the 6th and the 8 on the G, but you mute that note in between the two. Now, I'm just a bit lazy, and I always use my 4th finger, but you can use either. So the first note is there. So I think it's 8. 6. It's 6 on that chord, shifts up 1, and then goes down to the 2nd fret. So that's 6, shift up 1 to the 7th, and then down to the 2nd fret. And the pattern's like this. Just like that, just slower. Okay, that bit's nice and easy. And that's the same shape for those three chords. 6 and 8, 7 and 9, 2 and 4. Okay, nice and easy. But again, if you want to see it with my 3rd finger instead, it's... But again, just over the years, I've got more comfortable using my 4th finger. It allows me to use my middle finger just to block any other notes. So I'm playing a bit heavy and sloppy. Like that, I'll do a bit better. I'm muting also that top string, just with my middle finger. Do it your way. Anyway, okay, carry on. So it's... And then the little riff that comes after that. Now, it's important that you hit both the A string and the D string on every one of these. That little drone from the A note gives the riff its kind of coolness. So we finger only the D string, but we always strike the A string. And the first note is on the 6th fret on the D, and that's a bend up and release. Quick note, that's bend, up and down, it's bend and release. And the reason we go up and down on that note is because we strike it again. So it's 1, here we go, 6, 6, 4, 2, 4, 6, and 9. Nice and slow. And that's the main riff. It's really, really nice and simple and easy, but it's really fun to play and effective, so I'll just run it through slowly. Also comes in again during the chorus, which I can show you real quickly. The chords at the start are slightly different. We play, so that's, I think it's 8 on the E chord there, which is my 1st finger on the 7th fret of the A, and then my 3rd or 4th on the 9th fret on the D and G string. That chord changes into a variation on the E, but I think it's an E flat. But basically, we're playing the 6th fret on the A and the 9th fret on the D. So you can go. And that last chord is just the octave riff there again, the B, which is my 1st finger on the 2nd fret. And my 4th finger, that's again how I use it, on the 4th fret. And then we mute that D there. So it's 4th on the G and muted on the D. So. And that runs exactly the same. whether it's the chorus or the verse, that runs exactly the same. Okay, so learn it, have fun with it, watch the playthrough a few times, the tab will give you an idea how it's done, and enjoy. Come back, hopefully check out some more of my videos, and give me any suggestions of stuff you want me to do, and I will do my best to try and do those. Like and subscribe, as I said, because you need to do that, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.